Hi guys, I am the Beardy Red Viking, and this is a review and footage of the Bruce Dickinson gig at Manchester Academy on Sunday the 19th of May.
Thank you.
again and welcome back to my channel, and thanks for joining me once again. Today, as mentioned in the intro, I'm going to be quickly running over the Bruce Dickinson gig this past weekend at Manchester Academy on Sunday the 19th of May, and I'm going to be showing you a few clips of that as well. So as some of you may know, some of you may not know, but I'd be surprised if you don't, if you are paying any attention to this video, because I imagine you're probably interested in Bruce Dickinson if you are. Bruce Dickinson played this last weekend at Manchester Academy, and he's also on tour around the UK as we speak as well. I didn't have a ticket for the gig because it sold out before I managed to get round to buy my tickets. I tend to buy a lot of my tickets last minute because I'm rubbish with money and I'm throwing it around here and there. So I usually end up being a bit last minute buying my tickets. Unfortunately, I missed out on getting one. But as it turned out, having spent a few good few weeks browsing on Twickets and places like that to try and get myself a reasonably priced ticket for this show, I actually got a message from a guy called Gary, who I've met at a few gigs around Manchester these last couple of years. He messaged me and said that he had a ticket that he had purchased but was no longer able to attend, and was I interested? I said, yes, I'm very interested, thank you very much. And I only paid face value, so he'd paid more than I paid him for it. It was very kind of him. Thank you, Gary, if you're watching, really appreciate that. Shame you couldn't make it, but I must admit I was pretty ecstatic when I saw that I was going to get the chance to go and see Bruce Dickinson, as I love Iron Maiden, I love Bruce Dickinson, I'm really enjoy a lot of his solo stuff. Some of it's pretty cheesy, let's be honest, but I don't mind a bit of cheese with some of my metal. And Bruce Dickinson's a legend. I know there's some people that don't particularly like the guy, but yeah, he's a legend, and I really wanted to go and see him. And I was really a big fan of the latest album, Mandrake Project, that came out a couple of months ago. I think it's fantastic. So I really wanted to go and see him live, so I was really pleased to get hold of a ticket. Also, my good friend Mastodon Mart, who is here on YouTube, he had a ticket and he was planning on going, and I was hoping to be able to go and meet up with him because I've not seen him for about a year. He was here for Maiden last year. Unfortunately, I didn't have a ticket for that, but we met up and had a couple of beers the day before the show, and I've not seen him since then, so it was good to catch up with Martin. And I also met his Mrs. Denise, who is absolutely lovely. So hello, if either of you are watching. Had a great time with yous on Sunday. While we were out in Manchester, because obviously we went for a few beers in the afternoon beforehand, we went to the Salisbury for a few beverages beforehand. Martin had a friend in the pub there, he knows, who is a member of the Iron Maiden fan club, as well as Martin is as well. And he's been to see Iron Maiden 45 times. He's that kind of fan, he goes around the world seeing them. But yeah, Martin wanted to do an interview with him because of how many times he'd seen him, his mind was blown. Then a bit later on that day, Arcee, if any of you know him, he's a friend of mine from round Stockport, sometimes watches some of these stuff, doesn't make videos or anything, but he's big into the metal scene. If you go to gigs in Manchester, you've probably met Arcee, he's a good dude. He turned up after several hours. He was supposed to be there about 3 o'clock as well, but he didn't turn up until about five, half five, maybe 6 o'clock. I can't remember exactly when it was he turned up. He messaged me saying that he had been shat the night before, which is something he often says when he has a few too many beverages. So he was a bit late. After a few drinks at the pub, we went down to the show probably around 7:30, maybe a little bit after that. I'm not entirely sure. I know doors opened at 7. We hadn't heard particularly good things about the support band. I can't remember their name, but we'd heard they were pretty generic rock. So I wasn't too fussed about seeing them. I'd rather spend some time in the pub with some people I've not seen for a while. So after a few delicious beverages at the pub, it was a sunny day, so needed to keep ourselves nice and refreshed. We headed down to the show for around about the time that Bruce was due to be on stage. He was due on stage around about 9 p.m. so we headed around 8:30-ish probably to get there in time. We arrived there, got a beer, got into a decent viewpoint, which is in the middle of the stage, a little bit further back than where the pit would normally be. Obviously, there wasn't really a pit for Bruce Dickinson because it's not that kind of show. But yeah, probably around about where the pit would normally be at a more aggressive show. And yeah, got ourselves in good position and we were there plenty of time. There was quite a long intro tape by my memory. As I say, I'd had a few beverages by this point. So yeah, I can't remember exactly how long it was, but to me, it felt quite long. You will see that, or a little bit of it, in the clips that I show. So after the longish, As I say, I think it was longish intro tape. The opening song was Accident of Birth, which is one of my favourites. I absolutely love that album and I love that song. It was a great set list in all. Obviously, it spanned through his career. He played quite a nice selection of songs from all of his albums. They played 4 off the new album, Mandrake Project, and 5 off the Chemical Wedding album, which is considered to be his best album, his masterpiece, if you like. I personally prefer Accident Birth, but Chemical Wedding is close. And to be honest, I think I might prefer the Mandrake Project because I've really, really got into that album. There's a few slight duffers towards the end of it, but I think there's a good 7 or 8 songs on that album that are absolutely fantastic. And I've got to know that album a lot recently because, yeah, I've played it loads since it came out. So, yeah, they played 4 from the new album. They played 5 from Chemical Wedding from 1998. And they played 1 or 2 each from the rest of his back catalogue. From his solo career, obviously. Played about 90 minutes or so. There was a break in the middle of the set. They came back to a cover of Frankenstein by the Edgar Winter Group after a bit of a drum solo and Brucey dicking around on a theremin for a few minutes, which was great fun. It was very entertaining. Solo, the drum solo, I know people don't like them, but I was very impressive. All the backing band were fantastic musicians, played a great set, played an absolutely stellar performance. And yeah, I've got to give my credit to not just Bruce, who was on fantastic form, possibly some of the best vocal form I've ever heard. I've seen Maiden a few times and nowhere near as many times as RC and the friend of Martin's, but I've seen them a few times over the years. And I think this might be the best I've ever heard Bruce Dickinson's voice sounding. He sounded fantastic. The rest of the band were absolutely on form and yeah, put on a fantastic show. They played songs like Abduction from Tyranny of Souls. They played Afterglow of Ragnarok from the new album. Sadly, they didn't play Eternity Has Failed, which is on the new album as well. Obviously, that's a song that Maiden played on the Book of Souls album. He's reimagined that slightly for his solo album. Apparently it was originally written for his solo band. But yeah, unfortunately we didn't play that song, which was a bit of a shame, but they played plenty of others. As I say, Tears of the Dragon from Balls to Picasso, which is considered to be one of his best songs, one of my favourites. They played Book of Thel and The Tower from Chemical Wedding. They actually closed with those two. And Jerusalem from Chemical Wedding, The Alchemist. Yeah, plenty of great tunes on there in the set list. An absolutely fantastic set list. Played about 1.5 hours. By the end of it, I had unfortunately gone a little bit low sugared, a little bit low blood sugared. I'm diabetic, as a lot of you will know. Some of you may not. So that wasn't great. So I had to go and stand at the back to get a bit of air, eat some sweeties and have a glass of water. So that wasn't great. So I missed, well, I didn't miss any of the set, but for about the last probably third of the set, I was towards the back. So that was a little bit disappointing, a bit of a shame. But Martin was back there and Denise as well. So it was good to be able to chat with them a little bit while we were watching the back end of the show. Anyway, it was a fantastic show. I just wanted to quickly do a little video discussing it and a little bit of a review of it. I really enjoyed myself. It was a great day meeting people, seeing people that I've not seen for quite a long time. Seeing RCO I've seen fairly recently, but I don't think I've seen him properly since probably February or something like that. So it's good to see him again. And yeah, it was great. A great day. Fantastic show. Really enjoyed it. I will end the video with a clip of Afterglow of Ragnarok from the new album, which is the opening track from the new album and the lead single for it. Hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you enjoy the clips. Thank you for watching. As I say, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, I'd appreciate you taking the time to leave a like, maybe leave a comment down below. And if you want to see more of my videos, you can subscribe down below as well if you choose to do so. And I hope to chat to you in the comments down below. Once again, thanks again for watching. Take care. BeardyRedViking, out.